here is our planet, Earth. And it's called the blue planet, the frozen planet, and the green planet. Here, Earth really supports life everywhere. Here, there are many ecosystems there, the wildlife, and most importantly, the people. But here, there are some scenes of the Earth like we've never seen before. The many more hatches are still being explored to see how much supports it. This series will take you into the Earth, to the ecosystem there. This will show you the amazing planet, the Earth, and its wildlife like you've ever seen before. And what we can do to help our amazing planet thrive. Here, this is the blue planet. Here, Earth is covered mostly by water. Rivers, lakes, fresh water, everything, but a lot of them all are the oceans. Here in the Pacific Ocean, it's the largest ocean of all. It's probably the most common. Here, there's water rising above, but underwater is a different story. Here, barnacles, dolphins gather here in the Pacific for a very important event. They've been using echolocation very recently to locate fish, which are the far most common prey. When the echo bounces back, they know exactly now what the prizes are. The clicking sounds do most of the work for them, while they keep swimming along to where the echo are. Here, they work together in the pod to hunt down their prey, since one by itself won't do it justice. So working together is the best way to hunt for fish. Here, the fish are right near the coast. Here, hunting and cuffs will be easier. And that's because some fish may not make it out alive on the edge, So, hunting the coast is a good hunting trap. Some fish have a secret weapon at their sleeves. They'll try to leap out of the dolphin's mouth to avoid death. Here, this will make it harder for the dolphins. The dolphins also got another trick up their sleeves. But together, they'll try to force the fish out of the water onto the coast. And when the fish get closer to the water, they'll try to pull it back down together. And then the feast will begin. Here, together, they might eventually eat a couple of fish. But now, they're leaving to make their way back home because some other animal is about to begin their feast. Here, sea lions get here on the coast too. Because they know that fish are near, and they're preparing to take a dive. Here, there's plenty of food to go around. But here, sea lions had to be cautious about eating, because while they're eating and hanging out at sea, predators are always watching. So they have to be on the lookout just in case. Here, ocean water is salt. Oceans were made of salt water. So, this is pretty good from real life here. But, there are more oceans than we think. Here, down to the bottom of the earth, there was another continent that was really harsh, and that was Antarctica. Antarctica is the most harshest place on Earth, and there's no civilization here. Nothing will survive it. Here, there are no trees, plants, or anything else here. Here, there are only ice. Thin ice. And here, the ice will sometimes melt all the time. Sometimes on the ice, there is water. This is known as the Atlantic Sea. There's only one pole in here. That's known as the South Pole. And there has been a pole here ever since. There's been a pole here to determine which pole it was, the north or the south. And this is defined as the South Pole. Now people used to live here. Now we live in our warmer continents, such as North America, South America, Africa, Europe, Asia, even Australia. And now Antarctica is an abandoned land. And now that land is now home to the many species of wildlife that exist here. Some scientists may not believe that many wildlife survive here due to climate change. But now animals are now making themselves comfortable. Especially strange ones. Here, a colony of emperor penguins and are marching away to the old breeding grounds where they were born. The breeding grounds can be thousands of kilometers away, but they're always prepared to face the harsh conditions. They travel day and night, no matter how much it takes to get there. finally, they arrived. So right now, it's time to search for a mate. Hear the female sound, will eventually track a mate. When as many calls are heard, then the male start looking for a mate. Finding a mate may not be easier than males. Sometimes there is competition. Thank you. But when a male can attract a female, that they'll definitely have a bright future ahead of us. Sooner than our checks, and now when checks are going up, that the last cycle must start all over again. Here in Antarctica, it's become very cold here. Very cold indeed. Nothing will become warmer. Here, the winds have been chilling, and the freeze are breezing everything. Here, there have been cases of a snowstorm ahead of us, which many Antarctica animals are feared of. With a storm strong like that, many animals will get sudden loss, including a check. Yeah, these storms may not last longer than 2 hours. So, everything has to take every precaution to be aware of with a snowstorm. Antarctica may have freezing temperatures, but our plants do deal with the coldness sometimes in hot places. That there are hot or cold places around the earth. Here, it still exists. Here in North America, there is a hot environment where some ecosystems thrive. In that place, it's a snowy and desert. Here, the snowy desert is the biggest part of North America, filled with all types of wildlife. From canyons to the largest grain of sand everywhere, life thrives here. Many classified animals live in the desert. Mammals, birds, reptiles, and amphibians. But scientists are looking forward to fish really thriving in desert, since deserts are such a harsh place for fish. Here, deserts only have a little water. Here, sometimes no water is seen. Monsoons usually depend on water, but not usually harsh like this. Without water is going bad. If you can't have water, nothing lives. But on land, life is pretty good itself. Here, the Diamondback ground snake has been drawn on other small mammals for survival. The tarantula, one of the biggest spiders ever. Here, they hunt prey twice their size. Many predators have been aware of this menace, and I'll try to stay away from it at all costs. But so do the prey. Here, toads have an aware tail, and there is no the danger of a spider. The toad can really outrun the spider, but not for very long. The spider got his prize when I was trying to inject it with a nasty venom. They are such the largest spiders in the world that can really take down prey and succeed. desert, a very wide open spaces. Here, there are lots of sand. And lots of cactus that can make it a forest. But here, the more habitats that are wide open spaces for them, for wildlife to roam and flee. These were the grasslands. Here, there are very long grasses. And they keep growing without a problem. Here, the grass population cannot be controlled by humans. But in these grasslands of the Sierra Leone of Africa can be controlled by another group. The herbivores. Here, that they'll be busy dying on grass to control the population and get under control. Zebras might be herbivores, but there are also other herbivores like the Serengeti. Wildebeest and gazelles are common too. Here, the only one about the grass for now. But there are also other things to watch out for. While being known for the fastest land animal on land, cheetahs do not sometimes catch their prey, sometimes fail. But what for gazelles? That's a different story. Because that's what the cheetah's favorite prey. And they will prey on the young. Young are sometimes not fast enough, sometimes fall victims to predators. And that will make an easy meal for a cheetah. failed hunt. Going on to different targets will make the hunt even more difficult. She had no choice but to rest. Right now, the gazelles are safe for now. Here, other animals have been down to these grasslands with so much food that they can get all the stuff they need to survive. Here, the elephants dwell on bark from trees. Here, there are a few trees to go around, so elephants may have to feast on leaves falling from the ground. But if there were too many trees growing here in the savannas, then the savanna of Africa might turn into a rainforest. Here, this is the Congo of Africa. Here, this has been a rainforest. Here, many animals live here. Most savanna animals do not. But there's been a new group of animals that have been dwelling in these Congos for years. And they're still here today, even though they're endangered. Rustler and gorillas. There are many of the other gorilla species of the Congo. Here, gorillas have been very well adapted to their surroundings. The main diet consists of leaves. Here, the leaves falling from the trees would do them good, even for the youngsters. They're usually aggressive. Gorillas are sometimes peaceful. Here, there are many things we don't want to do around here, like getting a piggyback ride from silverbacks. But sometimes on their moms. Here, the almonds have amazing to learn before they're fully grown. But they won't be able to fully grown without the protection of the Congo. Here, trees have been cut down for development, and now these girls are now losing their homes. There's no telling how high the numbers are, but they might be close to 100,000. Even moving to a new home will save these species, since they dwell in their old homes better. Now, conservation is still learning more about gorillas, and what we can do to help protect them from generations to come of our ancestors. Here, in our planet, was our home, North America. North America has more wildlife than we know it, next to Africa. Here, there are most species we know today, but they still exist today. And when we know them, comes from the forest. Here, forests are later to jungles. But forests don't get rain. Here, forests stay dry and do sometimes get rain. These are sometimes called seasonal forests and temperate forests. But here, the millions of forests we know today are across the world. When there's forests, wildlife made themselves at home. In Alaskan wetlands, live one of the most remarkable bears of all. Here, black bears normally scratch to get the itch off, and spend most of the time chilling. Here's like getting their own massage and letting the floor do all the work. Sometimes, there are other better places to get massaged than the floor. Like, under a shady tree. After a girl massage, time to go search for a snack. Here, bed bugs on the floor might be good. And not try under the leaves. Since we're waking up for winter hibernation, black bears go around the forest for food. Cause there's more food to go around the forest than anywhere else. Without these forests, black bears will die off, becoming an extinct bear species next to the cave bear. By now, with the battle of the planet coming to our hands, we humans had to ask ourselves what the future will hold of the amazing planet on Earth.